This video goes over how to prepare a production cost report using the weighted average method. Again, in process costing environment, we don't trace costs to individual units. Rather, we need to calculate an average cost per unit. To calculate an average cost per unit, we'll take our total manufacturing cost that we have incurred, in this case, $600,000, and divide it by our 10,000 units to get an average cost per unit of $60. We're going to be moving through our examples here, going from very simple presentations to a full-blown production cost report. And each step of the way, we'll add a little bit of complexity. Let's go on to example 1B. In example 1B, we're told that we've got $50,000 in beginning work in process cost. We add to that in the current period $550,000 in manufacturing costs, giving us a total cost that we need to account for of $600,000. Since we have 10,000 units, our average cost per unit is again $60, which is the $600,000 in total cost divided by $10,000. Please take a minute and pause the video and work through the next example. In example 1C, we're given $50,000 in beginning work in process cost. We add to it $150,000 in direct material cost, $300,000 in direct labor cost, $100,000 in applied manufacturing overhead, for the same $600,000 in total cost. Since we have 10,000 units, once again, our average cost per unit is $60. In moving on to examples 2A and 2B, we need to recall the difference between fully completed units and partially completed units. And our partially completed units gave rise to the notion of equivalent units of production. Two half-completed products are the equivalent to one completed product. If you had two half a beers, it's the same thing as having one full beer. Two half a pizzas is equivalent to having one full pizza. So if we had 10,000 units that were 70% complete, we would say it's equivalent to 77,000 completed units, or we would say 7,000 equivalent units. Let's return to our example. In example 2A, we have $507,600 worth of costs that we need to account for. Notice we have costs over in this box, and in our box in the middle, we're going to be looking at our units. In terms of units, we're told that we have 9,000 fully completed units. And of course, those are units that we would transfer out to finished goods or the next department. We have 1,000 partially completed units for a total of 10,000 units. Recall, any units that we transfer out are 100% complete with respect to materials, overhead, and labor in the particular department that we're dealing with, or if we're moving them to finished goods in terms of work in process altogether. So again, anything that we transfer out is 100% complete. So we would say we have 9,000 equivalent units. With respect to our ending inventory, we're told that it's 40% complete. So 40% times 1,000 units in ending work in process gives us 400 equivalent units. This means our total equivalent units is 9,400 units. That's the 9,000 we transferred out and the 400 equivalent units in ending work in process inventory. Once again, we need to calculate our average cost per unit. And to do this, we take the total $507,600 in cost and divide it by the 9,400 equivalent units. And we get an average cost per unit of $54. In terms of the costs that are transferred out, since we've transferred out 9,000 equivalent units at a cost of $54 per unit, we will say we transferred out $486,000 will be leaving work in process and going to cost of goods manufactured. The cost that are remaining in ending work in process inventory will be the 400 equivalent units times $54 per unit, or $21,600. And notice the cost that we've accounted for, transferred out, or in ending work in process, is equal to the $507,000 in cost that we had to account for. Please, once again, take a moment, pause the video, and work through the next example before checking your answer. In example 2b, we have $507,600 in cost to account for. We're told that we have 7,200 fully completed units. Those will be transferred out. And that we have 1,000 units in ending work in process for a total of 8,200 units. Anything that we transfer out is 100% complete, so we'll have 7,200 equivalent units. Our ending work in process, we're told, is 80% complete, so 80% times the 1,000 units is 800 equivalent units. So we have a total of 8,000 equivalent units. That's the 7,200 that we transferred out, which were, again, 100% complete, and the 800 equivalent units in ending work in process inventory. Our average cost per unit, then, is $63.45. That's our total cost of $507,600 divided by the 8,000 equivalent units. The cost of the units that are transferred out will be $456,840. That's the 7,200 equivalent units times $63.45 per unit. And again, that's the cost that is transferred out of work in process to finished goods inventory or the next work in process department. In terms of the cost in ending work in process inventory, we have $50,760 in cost. That's the 800 equivalent units times $63.45. So those are the costs remaining in ending work in process inventory. And again, the cost that we've accounted for, the $507,600, equals the cost that we had to account for at the beginning. In example 3, we're going to go through again the same process. We're going to make it slightly more complex. In this case, we're going to need to calculate the partially completed units in ending work in process inventory. To begin with, we're told that we have a total cost of $484,000 to account for. Our beginning work in process inventory in units is 1,000 units. We start into production 9,000 units, which gives us a total of 10,000 units we need to account for. If we've completed 8,000 units, that means that our ending work in process will consist of 2,000 units. That's the 10,000 units we have to account for, minus the 8,000 units that we have transferred out. In terms of equivalent units, anything that we transfer out will be 100% complete with respect to materials, overhead, and labor. Our ending work in process, we're told, is 40% complete. So 40% complete times 2,000 units gives us 800 equivalent units. So our total equivalent units is 8,800. That's the 8,000 we've transferred out, again, 100% complete. And the 2,000 in ending work in process, which were 40% complete. Our average cost per unit then is $55. That's our total cost of $484,000 divided by our 8,800 equivalent units. In terms of costs that are transferred out, again, we've got 8,000 units we've transferred out. 8,000 units times $55 a unit means we will take $440 out of work in process, and it will flow into finished goods inventory or the next work in process production account. In terms of cost of ending work in process inventory, we've got 800 equivalent units at $55 a unit, or $44,000 in cost in ending inventory. And again, the total cost that we have to account for, the $484,000 in work in process, equals the cost that we began with that we needed to account for. Again, please take a minute and pause the video and work through example 3b. In example 3b, we're told that the total cost we have to account for is $484,000. Our beginning units in work in process is 2,000. We start into production 8,000 units, so we have total units we need to account for of 10,000 units. We're told that our partially completed units in ending work in process consist of 3,000 units, which means the completed units that we've transferred out equals 7,000 units. That's the 10,000 we need to account for, minus the 3,000 in ending work in process inventory. In terms of equivalent units, anything that we transfer out is 100% complete with respect to all costs. And our ending work in process, we're told, is 60% complete. So 60% times 3,000 units gives us 1,800 equivalent units of production. Our total equivalent units then is 8,800 units, 7,000 that are fully complete and transferred out, and 1,800 in ending work in process. Our average cost per unit then is $55, which again is our $484,000 in costs divided by our 8,800 equivalent units. The cost that we transfer out then will be the 7,000 units that have been transferred out times $55 a unit, or $385,000. And again, that cost leaves work in process and goes to finished goods or the next production department. Cost in remaining in ending work in process inventory are $99,000. That's the 1,800 equivalent units times $55 per unit. Go ahead again and pause the video and try working example 3C. In example 3C, rather than giving one total cost number, we're given individual components of our costs. Our beginning work in process cost, we're told, is $50,000. We have $150,000 in direct material cost, $300,000 in direct labor cost, $100,000 in applied manufacturing overhead, for a total cost to account for of $600,000. And again, we're going to need to calculate an average cost per unit, so we need to calculate our equivalent units of production. We're told that we began with 2,100 units in work in process. We started into production or added 9,000 units for a total of 11,100 units. We have 8,100 units that are fully completed, which will be transferred out to the next department, which means our ending work in process has 3,000 partially completed units. That's the 11,100 units to account for, minus the 8,100 that were transferred out. In terms of equivalent units, anything that's transferred out is 100% complete, and our ending work in process consists of units that are 50% complete, so we have 1,500 equivalent units of production. Total equivalent units then is 9,600. That's the 8,100 units we've transferred out times 100%, and the 3,000 units in ending work in process that are partially completed at a 50% level. Our average cost per unit then is our total cost of $600,000 divided by 9,600 equivalent units of production, or $62.50. The cost of the units transferred out will take the $62.50 per unit multiplied by the 8,100 units that were transferred out. In terms of ending work in process inventory, we've got the same $62.50 per unit times 1,500 equivalent units. And we notice that the $506,000 in cost transferred out plus the $93,000 in ending work in process equals the $600,000 in total cost that we had to account for. In our last example, we're going to consider the case where our direct materials and our labor and overhead are not added to our production process at an equal rate. Consider, for instance, a bakery where our ingredients are added at the beginning of the process, and then we bake, say, our bread and then slice the bread, or a brewery where our malt, barley, and hops and water are added, and those are, again, our direct materials are added at the beginning of the process, and then over time we go through the brewing process. Or even an assembly process where all of our parts are brought out of raw materials and put on the production floor at the beginning of a period. So we've incurred 100% of our direct material cost, but then the assembly process begins, and at a particular point in time when we stop and want to prepare a production report, let's say we're only 20% complete with respect to direct labor and overhead, which are our conversion costs. In this case, what we're going to need to do is split our production process or report down into two parts. One, we're going to look at direct materials. And then secondly, we'll look at labor and overhead. And then finally, we'll combine the two to get a total cost of units that were transferred out and the total cost remaining in ending work in process inventory. So to begin with, we're going to consider units with respect to direct materials and cost with respect to direct materials. Then after that, we'll consider units with respect to conversion costs and our conversion costs themselves. So let's go ahead and begin our problem. Our beginning direct material cost is $15,000. During the period, we add $150,000 in direct materials cost for a total cost that we're going to need to account for of $165,000. In terms of units, we're told that our beginning units are 2,000, that we started into production 9,000 units, and again, that was given, and we were also told that we had 10,000 completed units that we've transferred out. Again, that was given. So we need to calculate our partially completed units. And our partially completed units, of course, will simply be the $11,100 total units minus the 10,000 units we transferred out. So our ending work in process will consist of 1,000 units. In terms of equivalent units, again, anything that's transferred out is 100% complete. So we have 10,000 equivalent units transferred out with respect to direct materials. And we have 1,000 equivalent units left in ending work in process with respect to direct materials. And again, that's our 1,000 partially completed units times the 100% estimated degree of completion, since we added all of our direct materials at the beginning of the process. We can now go ahead and calculate our total costs and total equivalent units for direct materials and an average cost per unit. Remember, our total cost we had to account for was $165,000. In terms of total equivalent units, we had 11,000 equivalent units. That's the 10,000 transferred out, 100% complete, and the 1,000 in ending work in process that were also 100% complete. Our average cost per unit then is $15 per unit. That's $165,000 in cost divided by 11,000 units. And the cost of the units transferred out will be $150,000. That's the 10,000 equivalent units times $15 per unit. And our ending inventory cost will be $15,000, which is the 1,000 units times $15 per unit. And we can notice that the $165,000 in cost we had to account for equals the $165,000 in cost that we have accounted for. Now we're going to go ahead and consider our direct labor and overhead cost, or our conversion costs. Our beginning cost with respect to direct labor and overhead is $50,000. And we see that right here. In terms of cost that we've added $300,000 in direct labor and $160,000 in manufacturing overhead, for a total cost to account for of $510,000. In terms of equivalent units, everything up here will be exactly the same. The only difference will be in our equivalent unit calculation for ending work in process. In our ending work in process, we've got 1,000 units, and they were 20% complete. So our ending work in process is 200 equivalent units. We can now go ahead and calculate our total cost and our average cost per equivalent unit with respect to conversion costs. Again, our total cost to account for, $510,000. We had 10,200 equivalent units. That's the 10,000 we transferred out and the 1,000 in ending work in process that were 20% complete, which means our average cost per unit is $50 per unit. And that's the 510 divided by 10,200 equivalent units. The cost transferred out will be the 10,000 units transferred out times $50 per unit. and the cost of ending work in process inventory will be the 200 equivalent units times $50 a unit, or $10,000. And the total cost we've accounted for, the $510,000, equals the cost that we had to account for. In terms of total cost, the total cost for beginning and added for direct materials and overhead was $675,000. That's the $165,000 plus the $510,000. In terms of our total equivalent units, we can't talk about total equivalent units because with respect to direct materials, we have 11,000 equivalent units. But with respect to conversion costs, we only had 10,200 equivalent units. So that's not a concept we can talk about. However, the average cost per unit would be $65 per unit. That's $15 for direct materials and $50 per unit with respect to conversion costs. In terms of the total cost of the units transferred out, that's $650,000, and we can calculate that by taking our 10,000 units multiplied by $65 per unit, or we can add together our direct material and our conversion costs. The total cost of ending work in process, we can't multiply and calculate. We have to simply add together the $15,000 in direct material cost and the $10,000 in conversion costs. Again, the easiest way to work these problems is to break them down and think about two separate problems, one involving direct materials and the other one labor and overhead. Pause the video for a moment and go ahead and work through example 4b using a two-column approach. In a two-column approach, we simply take the given information and really break it into just two separate problems, one with respect to direct materials, and then we move the other bit of information we need over and work a second problem with respect to our conversion costs. Let's go ahead and take a look at it with our direct materials. In terms of partially completed units, we've got 1,000 partially completed units. That's the 11,000 in units on the left-hand side, which was our beginning of 2,000, plus 9,000 added to production, minus the 10,000 completed units. In terms of equivalent units, we'll have 11,000 total equivalent units. That's the 10,000 that were transferred out times 100%, or 10,000 equivalent units. And the 1,000 that are in ending work in process that, again, are 100% complete with respect to direct materials. So we have 11,000 total equivalent units. Our average cost per unit is simply our $165,000 in total cost divided by 11,000 units, giving us an average cost per unit of $15. In terms of cost transferred out, we simply take our 10,000 units that were completed and transferred out times $15 a unit for $150,000, and the cost of ending inventory then would be $15,000. Which is the 1,000 equivalent units in ending work in process times the same $15 per unit. For conversion costs, our partially completed units is again 1,000 partially completed units, which is the 11,000 units we had to account for, minus the 10,000 that were transferred out. In terms of total equivalent units, we've got 10,200 total equivalent units. That's the 10,000 that were transferred out times 100% because they're fully completed, and the 20% estimated completion times the 1,000 partially completed units for an additional 200 or 10,200 total equivalent units. Our average cost per unit will simply be our total cost that we had to account for of $510,000. That's the 50 in beginning, plus the 300 for direct labor and 160,000 for manufacturing overhead, divided by the 10,000 equivalent units. In terms of cost transferred out, we simply take our cost per unit of $50 per unit, multiplied by the 10,000 units that were fully completed and transferred out. The cost of ending inventory will be $10,000, which is our 200 equivalent units times $50 per equivalent unit. We can work these as separate problems, and then, of course, combine the columns to calculate our total cost transferred out and our total cost of ending inventory. And we get the same numbers we did in the previous example.